Hey folks, I'm HP and today I'm gonna talk about Dust My Broom. It's a blues standard. But before we get started, make sure to subscribe to my channel, hit the notification button. This way you can get informed when new videos upload. Our live stream is taking place. So, Dust My Broom. You need a bottleneck. I'm gonna show a version without bottleneck as well if you don't have a bottleneck. But if it's a really cool thing, it's really cheap, put it on your finger. And let's get started. So it's a very signature bottleneck intro. As I said, you can also play without bottleneck, but first I'm going to show the bottleneck and give a short introduction into bottleneck tech. It's really simple. I mean, bottleneck, you just put a glass thing or a metal thing on your finger, put it on the strings and the fretboards. Fretboards are the place where you put them and then try to slide above the fretboard like this and don't press too hard. That's the main trick. So let's get started. Okay guys, here is now, we're in D, so the bottleneck, you can put it on any finger. Oops, I recommend, I take it on the pinky and just hold it with my ring finger like this. But you can do as you like. I would recommend this because otherwise you cannot play the chords. That's really simple. You play with finger picking and then we are in the 10th fret and you 10 triplets. 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So this is the main figure, but you slide in. See? And the end is. Comes pretty fast, so. Then you. You play the triplet three times, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, and so. That's basically how it's played without the bottleneck. But with the bottleneck, it's a little bit harder to really get also in the tempo, so. And also the ending chord, this one here in the 7th fret. Oh, by the way, it's a normal tune guitar, so. Well, you can probably, the guy, tune it on a chord, but I play with normal tune guitar, so. Then you have this chord. This comes twice. Again. And then comes the figure. Comes a figure here, slide from 7 to 10, and then 10 again, back to 7, then we go to G. And I would play it here because you cannot play it like this because you have a bottleneck here. So you play G, 3rd fret here, 2nd fret on the D string, and the open D string. Okay, so I'm gonna play with the track now. That's the original tempo. 2, 3. That was the whole figure. So let's complete the rest. We were with G5 and I play with finger picking here with thumb, index. See? The normal figure. So here, third fret open D string 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and then comes the figure again. And then comes the same figure on A5, so open A string, second fret here. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and to G5 as the same figure as before. And then comes an ending, but it's actually played with the piano in the original recording, but we can do something similar. We do the same as above here, but now here in the 7th fret on the G and B string in triplets. 1, 2, 3, 9, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. And then 3, 4, 5. So see, you can, or you can play with the finger or with the bottleneck. And that's it. So I'm gonna play now the whole thing with bottleneck, and then I make a break and play the whole thing without bottleneck. Without bottleneck is the same thing, you just, well, I'm gonna show you. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2. That was now the bottleneck version, and as I said, if you don't like bottleneck but you still love the song, same thing, like this, index finger. Then 10, 10, 7, 7, 7. Again. Then everything is pretty similar. So I'm gonna play now without, but it's cooler with bottleneck, I must say. As I said, with or without bottleneck, I would prefer bottleneck. And as I said, the trick is just lay it down on your guitar, and it helps if you're, that's why I didn't take Dr. Pink today, I must say, because Dr. Pink's strings are really flat on the fretboard. And here, it's better to have a certain distance between the fretboard and the strings. Some slide guitars are really high, they're really set on a high level, to avoid that you get down on the fretboards. If you have a low string setting, then just don't press too hard, that you don't press the strings down on the fretboards, because then it will not work. Yeah, folks, one more to say. That's basically, I mean, it's pretty simple, the song. I love it. It's an old song. I used to, when I started my music career, as one of the songs I always wanted to play, so now I took it in my tutorials. If you want to download the tabs and the backing track for this one, it's available at the HPCrazy Guitar Academy. Join there. If you want to show me how you manage the lesson, you can also, you can post your recording there. Just record a video of yours, upload it to YouTube, and make a link to my channel. Post your video there in the Students Club, and then wait for comments, reviews of other students, or maybe if I have time, I'll also check it out. It's really worth it, it's fun. Join there, it's cool. Good, and what more to say, join me on Telegram, HPCrazy. Join me on Instagram, join me on Spotify, on Google. You can follow me, and the rest I don't really feed anymore. Facebook for me, these times are over. I don't like Facebook. Yeah, that's more about that. And write me in the comments if you want to have more slide guitar. I mean, I know some slide guitar, it's really cool. So you can do really cool stuff. If you want to know more about slide guitar, let me know in the comments. If you have any other suggestions about blues songs which you like to learn, write me in the comments, or just let me know other suggestions what you like to know from me. Me and Dr. Pink is now not here, but this acoustic department here, we are there for you guys. Yeah.